We are going to start a new topic, a series of lectures about the cholinergic drugs. So cholinergic drugs are those drugs which modify the action of acetylcholine in our body. These cholinergic drugs, either they increase the action of the acetylcholine which is produced in our body, or they decrease the action of acetylcholine which is produced in our body. So we were discussing about the cholinergic drugs. So before we really talk about the cholinergic drugs, first we have to understand the basic physiology about the acetylcholine. So I've told you that the cholinergic drugs are those drugs which modify the action of acetylcholine. Know that acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter which is made in your body. So the and we call the drugs which are cholinergic, which modify the action of the acetylcholine which is produced in our body. Either these drugs, they increase the action of acetylcholine, or they decrease the action of acetylcholine. And we call these types of drugs which modify the action of acetylcholine as a cholinergic drugs. Now, before we discuss about the cholinergic drugs, first we have to understand that what are the areas where the acetylcholine is produced and released. So please tell me that where the acetylcholine is produced in our body. Can you please tell me, class? Class, are you with me? So tell me, where is the acetylcholine is produced? In the neurons. Can you please tell me, Zen, where are these neurons located? Which are the neurons which produced the acetylcholine? My question is simple, and I'm just asking where the acetylcholine is produced. The presynaptic membrane and the postsynaptic membranes are the part of the neurons. It is produced by enzymes. I'm asking about the neurons. You have told it right, Azan, that the acetylcholine is produced by the neurons. You have said it right. And you know that the neurons which produce the acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter, these neurons are known as the cholinergic neurons. Next time when I say cholinergic neuron, it should come into your mind that this is a neuron which produces acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter, right? And we have discussed about the adrenergic neurons, and you know that adrenergic neurons are those neurons which produce the norepinephrine as a neurotransmitter, right? So the cholinergic neurons are the neurons which produce the acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter. So the cholinergic drugs must be acting on the cholinergic neurons, right? Now we try to understand that where these cholinergic neurons are located, then we will able to understand the action of the drugs. So you must be remembering, I hope, that we have the parasympathetic nervous system and the sympathetic nervous system, and we also have a somatic nervous system. You remember, class, we have a sympathetic nervous system, we have the parasympathetic nervous system, and we also have the somatic nervous system. Right. So, and you also must be remembering that that the somatic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system, we have preganglionic neurons and we have also postganglionic neuron. Remember, class, that in the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system, these are the two types of autonomic nervous system, and which consist of the preganglionic neuron and the postganglionic neuron. I will not go into the detail now. So the preganglionic neuron and the postganglionic neuron are also the part of the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. Now, if we talk about the parasympathetic nervous system, right? In the parasympathetic nervous system, we have the preganglionic neuron and we have the postganglionic neuron, right? This is the ganglia. These are the autonomic ganglia. So this is the preganglionic neuron, which is coming out from the central nervous system. And this is the postganglionic neuron, which is coming out after forming the synapse in the ganglia. Now, I'm first talking about the parasympathetic nervous system. Now, remember that in the parasympathetic nervous system, the preganglionic neuron and the postganglionic neuron, they both are the cholinergic neurons. It means that the preganglionic neuron releases acetylcholine and the postganglionic neuron also releases acetylcholine. Right, class? So in the parasympathetic nervous system, both the preganglionic and the postganglionic neuron are the cholinergic neurons. Right. Then we talk about the sympathetic nervous system. And in the sympathetic nervous system, you know that we have the preganglionic neuron and the postganglionic neuron. Now, in the sympathetic nervous system, the preganglionic neuron are the cholinergic neuron. It means that the preganglionic neuron of the sympathetic nervous system release acetylcholine. But you know that the postganglionic neuron of the sympathetic nervous system, they do not release acetylcholine. They release the norepinephrine. So the postganglionic neuron of the sympathetic nervous system are the adrenergic neurons. Right, class? So in the sympathetic nervous system, the preganglionic neuron is a cholinergic neuron and the postganglionic neuron of the sympathetic nervous system is the adrenergic neuron. This is the difference between the parasympathetic and the sympathetic. In the parasympathetic, both the preganglionic and the postganglionic are the cholinergic neurons, whereas in the sympathetic nervous system, only the preganglionic neuron is a cholinergic neuron. Right? And you know that in the sympathetic nervous system, there are some neurons which are coming out from the central nervous system, but they do not form the synapse in the autonomic ganglia. Instead, they go directly to the adrenal medulla and they release the epinephrine. We have discussed this basic anatomy in the last semester. So the sympathetic innervations, which are going directly innervating the adrenal medulla, they also release the acetylcholine. So the neurons which are directly innervating the adrenal medulla, these are also the cholinergic neurons. Right, class? And beside the sympathetic and the parasympathetic nervous system, we also have third nervous system, which is known as the somatic nervous system. This is the nervous system, which is innervating their nerves directly to the skeletal muscles, right, which is under your control. So therefore, it is known as the somatic nervous system. And the neurons which are forming the somatic nervous system, all the motor neurons in the somatic nervous system, they are also the cholinergic neurons. It means that these motor neurons all releases the acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter. Right, class? Is that clear? So in the parasympathetic nervous system, the preganglionic neuron and the postganglionic neuron, they both are the cholinergic neurons. In the sympathetic nervous system, only the preganglionic neurons are the cholinergic neurons. And in the somatic nervous system, all the motor neurons in the somatic nervous system, they are also the cholinergic neurons. Right, class? Is that clear? So you have to remember this, that where are the cholinergic neurons are there, then you will able to understand the action of the drugs. Then sympathetic innervation आपकी जो preganglionic neuron होती है वो आपकी acetylcholine release करती है, और जो postganglionic neuron होती है वो आपकी norepinephrine release करती है. तो जो preganglionic neuron है sympathetic nervous system में वो cholinergic neuron है, और जो postganglionic neuron sympathetic nervous system में होती है वो adrenergic neurons होती हैं, क्योंकि वो norepinephrine release करती हैं. जबकि parasympathetic nervous system में preganglionic neurons और postganglionic neurons दोनों cholinergic neurons होती हैं, दोनों acetylcholine release करती हैं as a neurotransmitter. और somatic nervous system में जो कि न्यूरॉन्स आपकी होती हैं, जो कि मोटर न्यूरॉन्स, जो कि आपके डायरेक्टली स्केलेटल मसल्स के जो जंक्शन होते हैं, जो कि आप जिसको न्यूरोमस्कुलर जंक्शंस भी कहते हैं, वो तमाम न्यूरॉन्स आपकी कोलिनर्जिक न्यूरॉन्स होती हैं, जो कि डायरेक्टली इनर्वेट कर रही होती हैं स्केलेटल मसल्स को, न्यूरोमस्कुलर जंक्शंस को, वो भी आपके एसिटाइलकोलिन रिलीज करती हैं. तो ये पॉसिबल ये साइट्स हैं आपकी जहाँ पे कोलिनर्जिक न्यूरॉन्स प्रेजेंट हैं. तो आप अगर कोई ड्रग देंगे, वो ड्रग इन न्यूरॉन्स पे जाके एक्शंस अपने शो करेंगी. तो ये एक्शंस आपके आपको ड्रग के मिलेंगे जब आपको इन न्यूरॉन्स की लोकेशन मालूम होगी कि स्केलेटल मसल्स पे जाके कोलिनर्जिक न्यूरॉन्स अपना एक्शन शो कर सकती है, क्योंकि वहां पे इनर्वेशन होती है कोलिनर्जिक न्यूरॉन्स की. इसके अलावा प्रीगैंग्लियोनिक न्यूरॉन्स सिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम पे एक्शन शो कर सकती हैं. इसके अलावा पैरासिंपैथेटिक में दोनों न्यूरॉन्स पे जाके अपना एक्शन शो कर सकती हैं. इज दैट क्लियर? Right, then we move ahead. This is what it has written, that the acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter, and all somatic motor neurons to the skeletal muscles are release acetylcholine. All the preganglionic, parasympathetic and the parasympathetic fibers, they release acetylcholine. And only the postganglionic parasympathetic fibers of are also released acetylcholine. And one thing I have to tell you, that in the sympathetic nervous system, I've told you that the postganglionic neurons are the adrenergic neurons, but there are some only few postganglionic neurons of the sympathetic nervous system which release acetylcholine. Only those postganglionic neurons of the sympathetic nervous system release acetylcholine, which are innervating the sweat glands. So all the postganglionic neurons of the sympathetic nervous system are the adrenergic neurons, but only those postganglionic neurons which are innervating the sweat glands, they release acetylcholine. Right, class? So this is the slight difference. This is the only difference. Is that clear, class? All the postganglionic neurons of the sympathetic nervous system, they release the norepinephrine. They are all adrenergic neurons. Only those postganglionic neurons of the sympathetic nervous system which are innervating the sweat glands, they produce acetylcholine. Only those postganglionic neurons are the cholinergic neurons which are innervating the sweat glands. This is the only difference. Right. So now after understanding the locations of the cholinergic neurons at the parasympathetic outflow, sympathetic outflows, and the somatic nervous system, now we will try to understand how the acetylcholine is produced in the neuron, in the cholinergic neuron, right? And to sum up this, I've already also, you can go through this, that the neurons which release acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter are the cholinergic neurons. Cholinergic neurons are in the central nervous system. It means that, you know, that the parasympathetic outflow is of the cranial, from the cranial regions and the sacral region. As the cranial regions are in the central nervous system in the brain, so therefore definitely the cholinergic neurons are there in the central nervous system also. Cholinergic neurons are also associated with the parasympathetic outflow and the sympathetic outflow, and all the motor neurons of the somatic nervous system are also the cholinergic neurons, right? We have discussed this, right? Now we will try to understand. Can you see this diagram and my pointer? Now we will try to understand how the acetylcholine is produced in the cholinergic neuron. You have already told me that the cholinergic neurons are the neurons which produce acetylcholine. So the acetylcholine is produced in the cholinergic neuron. So this is the cholinergic neuron, and the acetylcholine is produced inside it. So how the acetylcholine is produced, let's discuss about it. Now for the acetylcholine production, you need the raw material. So the first raw material which you need for the production of this acetylcholine is the choline, C-H-O-L-I-N-E. And from where you are getting this choline? You are getting this choline from your diet. And you know that the choline is a nutrition which is in the vegetables, fruits. So from the diet, when you take these fruits or the vegetable from your GIT, it is absorbed in your blood, and from the blood that choline goes into the extracellular space. And from the extracellular space, these cholinergic neurons will pick up the choline, right? So the choline is coming into the cholinergic neurons from your diet. This is the nutrition. Choline is a nutrition which is present in the vegetables and fruits. So choline pick up by the cholinergic neurons. And how the choline is pick up by the cholinergic neuron? Choline is pick up by the cholinergic neurons by special transporters which are present on the membrane of the cholinergic neurons. So choline pick up by the choline transporter, and the choline comes inside the cholinergic neuron, and then this choline combines with another product which is known as the acetyl-CoA. This is the acetyl-CoA. Now, from where this acetyl-CoA is coming? Can anyone tell me from this acetyl-CoA is coming? Did you learn about the Krebs cycle biochemistry? Very good. So I'm not going into the detail of the Krebs cycle, but I'm just asking the simple question. Can anyone tell me from where this acetyl CoA is coming? This is a very simple question. At least you should know from where the things are coming into the cholinergic neurons. This acetyl, you know that your neurons also have the mitochondria. Your neurons also have a lot of mitochondria. From the mitochondria, this acetyl-CoA is coming, right? So the choline, then combines with an acetyl-CoA, which is coming from the mitochondria, which are present in your cholinergic neurons. And the choline then combines with an acetyl-CoA, and you need an enzyme also, so that the choline and acetyl-CoA can combine. And the enzyme which you need is, if I'm not wrong, that enzyme is acetyl-CoA transferase. Acetyl-CoA transferase. So the choline and the acetyl-CoA combine with each other by the enzyme acetyl-CoA transferase. And what you get? You will then get acetylcholine, right? So very simple step. You need the choline and you need the acetyl-CoA. Choline is coming from your diet. Acetyl-CoA is coming from the mitochondria. Choline and acetyl-CoA combined by the enzyme acetyl-CoA transferase. And what you get? You get acetylcholine. So this is the acetylcholine which you get. Now, if you remember that we have discussed in the adrenergic sections that the norepinephrine is produced by the neuron, and that norepinephrine which is produced, that norepinephrine is stored in the vesicle. Remember class? Why? Because if it is not stored in the vesicle, that norepinephrine can be degraded by a cat, which is known as a mouse. But in that case, acetylcholine is not being degraded by the MAO. Instead, it can be degraded by other enzymes, which we will not discussing right now. So the acetylcholine has to go into the vesicle in order to protect from the different substance which can destroy the acetylcholine. So the acetylcholine, after the production of the acetylcholine, that acetylcholine is stored in the vesicle. This is the vesicle. And the acetylcholine goes into the vesicle by some special transporters which are present on the membrane of the vesicle, which transport the acetylcholine from outside to inside the vesicle, right? So now the acetylcholine is inside the vesicle, safe and ready to release. Right, so now the acetylcholine is produced and is stored in the vesicle. Now that acetylcholine which is stored in the vesicle, now it is ready to be released. And how it is, and how it will be released, how it will be released? It will be released when there is a need for the acetylcholine to be released outside. So when there is a need of the release, the body has several mechanism which determines that then there is a need of the release of the acetylcholine. So when there is a need of the release of the acetylcholine outside the cholinergic neuron, then the action potential arrives at the cholinergic neurons. And you know that when the action potential arrives by the influx of the sodium inside the cholinergic neuron. And when the sodium comes inside, as the sodium is a positive charge, so the membrane will lose the negative polarity. So we say that the membrane becomes depolarized. So after the influx of the sodium into the cholinergic neuron, the membrane becomes depolarized. And you know that there are some special calcium channels which are present on the membrane of the cholinergic neurons, and these calcium channels are sodium sensitive calcium channels. When the sodium comes inside the cholinergic neurons, these calcium channels will be open because they are sodium sensitive calcium channels. And when they sense the sodium which is coming inside, these calcium channels will be open. So these calcium channels will only be open when the membrane becomes depolarized. So after the influx of the sodium inside the cholinergic neurons, these calcium channels will be open, and you know that when the calcium channel opens, calcium comes from outside to the inside. And when the calcium comes from outside to the inside of the cholinergic neuron, this calcium will help the release of the acetylcholine, which is stored in the vesicle. Right, class? So the acetylcholine, which is stored in the vesicle, that acetylcholine will be released outside the cholinergic neurons. So this calcium, which is coming inside, will help to fuse this vesicle with the membrane of the cholinergic neurons, and with the fusion of the vesicle with the cholinergic neurons, the acetylcholine released outside. Now the acetylcholine is at the synaptic area or the synaptic cleft area. Are you getting my point, class? So what I've told you, that when the acetylcholine is produced, that acetylcholine is stored in the vesicle, and when it is stored in the vesicle, and when there is a need for the release of the acetylcholine, an action potential arrives, and the sodium comes inside, and there are calcium channels also which are present on the membrane of the cholinergic neurons. These calcium channels are sodium sensitive calcium channels. They open, and the calcium come inside. And what the calcium will do, the calcium will help to fuse this vesicle with the cholinergic neurons membrane, and after the fusion, the acetylcholine will come outside. So this is the mechanism. I am giving so much detail about that because many drugs will act on that process. Many drugs will act on that machinery and will alter the action of the acetylcholine. So therefore, you have to understand this, what is happening around. So the acetylcholine then comes outside into the synaptic area or the synaptic cleft. And then there are the receptors for the acetylcholine, which are present on the effector organ. And the acetylcholine will produce its action by binding to these receptors. And the acetylcholine, after the release of the acetylcholine from the cholinergic neurons, after the release of the acetylcholine from the cholinergic neurons, some acetylcholine then will bind to the presynaptic receptors, same as in the case of the adrenergic case. So this acetylcholine then bind to the presynaptic receptor and will give a negative feedback to stop the further release of the acetylcholine, as it has enough acetylcholine in the synaptic area. So some acetylcholine will bind to this presynaptic receptor, which gives a negative feedback for the release of the acetylcholine, and some acetylcholine will be broken down into the choline and acetate. Some acetylcholine will be broken down into what? Choline and acetate by an enzyme which is known as the acetylcholine esterase. Acetylcholine esterase are the enzymes which are abundantly present in the synaptic area. When the acetylcholine comes into the synaptic area, acetylcholine esterase enzymes act on the acetylcholine and will break down the acetylcholine into the choline and acetate. Remember, in the case of the adrenergic drugs, we have discussed that when the norepinephrine comes out in the synaptic area, there were no significant enzymes which will break down the norepinephrine. The whole norepinephrine recycle back into the cholinergic neuron. But in the case of the cholinergic neurons, that when the acetylcholine comes into the synaptic area, we have sufficient amount of the acetylcholine esterase enzyme, which are present in the synaptic area. This acetylcholine esterase enzymes act on the acetylcholine and break down the acetylcholine into the choline and acetate, which will terminate the action of the acetylcholine further. Right? So the acetylcholine will not be able to reutilize fully, as the norepinephrine was reutilizing again. So the acetylcholine is being broken down into the choline and acetate. Instead, the choline, choline from the acetylcholine breakdown, this choline is then recycled back. this choline then further this choline then again pick up by the cholinergic neurons and can be again reutilized for the making the acetylcholine. Are you getting my point, class? I am telling you the difference between the norepinephrine and the acetylcholine. When the norepinephrine has came out from the adrenergic neuron, that norepinephrine wholly can be reutilized. But in the case of the acetylcholine wholly cannot be reutilized. Instead, because in the synaptic area we have acetylcholine esterase enzyme. That acetylcholine esterase enzyme break down the acetylcholine into the choline and acetate. The acetate will then be removed outside from the body, and the choline can be reutilized back for the production of the acetylcholine. So this is the process by which you are getting the acetylcholine. How you are getting acetylcholine? Let's sum it up. You are getting the choline from the diet. Choline comes inside into the cholinergic neuron by the special transporter, which are known as the choline transporter. Then that choline combines with an acetyl-CoA, which is coming from the mitochondria. And then the choline and the acetyl-CoA combines with each other by an enzyme, which is known as the acetyl-CoA transferase. And what you get, you will get the acetylcholine. Then that acetylcholine comes inside the synaptic vesicle by the special transporters, which are also present on the synaptic membrane, in the synaptic vesicle membrane. And then it is stored in the vesicle. And when there is a need for the release of the acetylcholine from this vesicle, the action potential occurs and the sodium comes inside the cholinergic neurons. That sodium will open the calcium channels and the calcium comes inside, and that calcium will help to fuse the synaptic vesicle with the cholinergic neuron membrane, and that acetylcholine will then be released from outside the cholinergic neurons. And when the acetylcholine comes outside the cholinergic neurons, and some acetylcholine will then bind to the presynaptic receptors, which will give a negative feedback to stop the further release of the acetylcholine, as we have enough acetylcholine in the synaptic area. And some acetylcholine will be broken down into the choline and acetate by an enzyme which is known as the acetylcholine esterase, which is present in the synaptic area. The acetate is then removed outside from the body, and the choline can be reutilized again for the production of the acetylcholine. So this is the basic mechanism how you are getting the acetylcholine and how you are terminating or decreasing the action of the acetylcholine inside your cholinergic neurons. So some key drugs which are working on this machinery, let's discuss about this drug. The choline which is coming inside the cholinergic neurons by the pump, which are known as the choline transporters, if you inhibit the activity of this pump, choline transporter, will choline be able to come inside the cholinergic neurons? Choline will not be able to come inside because you are inhibiting the choline transporter pump. So when the choline will not be able to come inside, so can you get the acetylcholine? You will not get acetylcholine. So you are cutting the production of the acetylcholine. You are making the production of acetylcholine half. So the drug which is blocking the activity of inhibiting the activity of this transporter, which is allowing the entry of the choline inside the cholinergic neuron, that drug is known as the hemicholinium. Hemicholinium. Why we are calling it hemicholinium? Because it is cutting down the production of the acetylcholine half. So for the memorization point of view, they have named the drug as an hemicholinium. So they are right, class. So this is the hemicholinium is a drug which is inhibiting the activity of the choline transporter. Now next is a drug which is known as the there is another drug which is inhibiting the release of the acetylcholine from the cholinergic neuron. And the drug which is inhibiting the release of the acetylcholine from the cholinergic neuron, that drug is known as the botulinum toxin. Botulinum toxin inhibiting the release of the acetylcholine from the synaptic vesicle into the outside the cholinergic neuron. The acetylcholine is produced, the acetylcholine is stored, but the acetylcholine is not able to release outside. So the acetyl, when there will be no release of the acetylcholine will not produce any action. So the drug which is inhibiting the release of the acetylcholine from the synaptic vesicle outside the cholinergic neuron, that drug is known as the botulinum toxin. So there are only two drugs which I am discussing right now. One is the hemicholinium and the other one is the botulinum toxin. Any question, class? Any question, class? We will discuss about the role of venom in the next class. As we are running short of time, we will discuss about it. Botulinum toxin inhibits the release of the acetylcholine. That's it. They are inhibiting the release. Acetylcholine is stored in the vesicle, but it is stopping the release of the acetylcholine outside the vesicle. Any question, class? So I'm again telling you, class, go through the books, remember the cholinergic systems, what are the possible, where are the cholinergic neurons located in the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system, and then you will be able to understand the action of the drugs. And in the case of, and we have discussed about the adrenergic drugs, and go through the books. I have not told you the simple side effect of the drugs, but you can illustrate, you can get an idea how the drug is producing the side effect in the adrenergic neurons. We have discussed enough about the adrenergic drugs, about the possible mechanisms, about the possible indications. So you can get an idea about the different side effects that the drug is giving you. Any question, class? We have now less than 1 minute. Okay, there will be one last class before the Eid, which I will schedule in a day or two, right? So then after Eid, we will continue that lecture.